Hi everyone, it's Tony here, and I've got some great news for you today. Soon, you'll be able to set up breakout rooms in Microsoft Teams before a meeting starts. According to the Microsoft roadmap, this is due for release in October 2021, so it's happening very, very soon. In this video today, I'm going to give you a sneak peek of how it works. Are you ready? I know I am. Then let's go. So here I have a meeting I prepared earlier. If I double click, and here I have the breakout rooms tab. You will only see this tab once you've sent the appointment. If I click here to get started, I click here, choose how many rooms I want to create, and I can do up to 50. I'm happy with 2. Click add rooms. The next step is to assign people to the rooms. So I click here to do that. So I can assign them automatically. So Teams will put them in the rooms randomly. But for this example, I'm going to go for the manual option just to show you how this works. So I click next. So here are my 4 attendees. So I can assign them to the room by clicking here. Or another way to do it is to click here and then click up here to assign those people to the rooms in one go. If you're working with a longer list of names, then you can search for the participants here. I'm happy with this, so let's click assign. So here I have the 2 rooms with the 2 participants in each room. If at any point I want to check these names or reorder it, then I just click assign participants and I've got my list here. And then it's just a matter of clicking on here to change. I'm happy with this. Other options available. If I click here, I can edit the name of the room. Another thing you can do is look at the meeting options. So to do this, if I click here and then go to settings, this will open up the meeting options into a browser window. And here you have the meeting options that you would expect for a normal Teams meeting. So for example, maybe I want the breakout rooms to be recorded automatically. So I click on this switch and then press save. This is done on a room by room basis. So you will need to repeat this process for each breakout room. Over here, you've got options to add rooms, to recreate the breakout rooms, to delete all rooms, or to go into the breakout room settings. But I'm happy with this, so let's click join, and then join now. And if I click here on the breakout rooms icon, and over here on the right, you can see those breakout rooms that are created before the meeting started. And once I'm ready to start those breakout rooms, I just click open. If you want help managing the breakout rooms, then watch this video here.